So I'm right. Actually, I'm not really qualified because there are so many senior Vaishnavas and also Maharaj is also there. So just I am praying at all of your lotus feet so that I can serve, I can talk something. So I'm not really a very qualified person, but somehow so I'm here. Okay, I will try to explain as much as I know, and if you find anything improvement in my things or anything mistake if I speak, so that please let me know so that I can revise it and I can improve myself. It's like a just teaching means it's all the time he is having his scope to improve more, because there are in the students they are even more qualified people are possible and they can suggest, and otherwise they may get good ideas, actually even better ideas than the teacher. So that whole life is like a learning, so till the end of the life, so I will always learn. So that's why I have that kind of ideology. So yeah, we'll try to explore more and more, but also we'll consider time and also some basic decency also we need to maintain in the class. That is also required. Okay, so Tattva Sandarbha, before going to start, so we'll first of all okay. ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्या ज्ञानांजनाशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येना तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददातु ईश्वरपदं जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्त हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे. So before going to start Sandarbhas, we need to recite the Mangalacharan. I sent one file. In that Mangalacharan slokas are there in that? No, no. So, but you sent to me, na Mangalacharan just one second. I will be sending the all the Mangalacharan slokas so that. In which file it is there, Prabhu? Yes, Prabhu. Day one notes you got. That is not having, na? Day. First logo, first verse only, okay.
Prabhuji, Mangalacharanam slokas are there in your text.
All are there?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay, you can, all of you can, we all together we do generally, because it will take much time. There are total 8 slokas are there. So that's every day we do this this Mangalacharana slokas recitation. Krishna Varnam Tvisha Krishnam Sango Pangastra Parshadam Yagnaihi Sankirtana Prayai Yajantihi Sumedhasaha Antah Krishnam Bahir Gauram Darshitangadi Vaibhavam कलौ संकीर्तनाच्यैस्मः कृष्ण चैतन्यमाश्रिता जयतां मथुरा भूमौ श्रील रूप सनातनौ यौ विलेकयतस्तत्त्वं ज्ञापकौ पुस्तिकामिमां कोऽपि तद्बान्धवो भट्टो दक्षिणद्विजवंशजः विविच्य वेलिकद्ग्रन्थम् लिखिताद् वृद्धवैष्णवैः तस्याद्यं ग्रंथनालेकं क्रांतव्युत्क्रांतखंडितं पर्यालोच्यात पर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः यः श्रीकृष्णपादाम्भोज भजनैकाभिलाषवान् तेनैव दृश्यतामेतत् अन्यस्मै शपथोऽर्पितः अथ नत्वा मन्त्रगुरून् गुरून् भागवतार्थदान् श्रीभागवतसन्दर्भं सन्दर्भं वश्मि लेखितुम् यस्य ब्रह्मेति संज्ञां क्वचिदपि निगमे याति चिन्मात्रसत्ता प्यंशो यस्यांशकैः स्वैर्विभवति यशयन्नेव मायां पुमांश्च एकं यस्यैव रूपं विलसति परमव्योम्नि नारायणाख्यं स श्रीकृष्णो विदत्तां स्वयमिह भगवान् प्रेम तत्पादभाजाम् So there are actually 9 slokas are there, but one sloka it is looking little bit unfitting. Anyway, we'll discuss that. So I recited 8 slokas. So,
sorry, Prabhuji, not there.
You said
all are not there, Prabhuji.
Yeah. Okay, no problem. So online, actually, total how many students are on the online? Nineteen total registrations 20. You have total that file, Prabhu Atul Gopal Prabhu. How many are absent?
No, here is 21, Prabhu. 19 online.
And for online students, there is a one rule actually. They have to put on the camera all the time, and everyone they should not off the camera. So otherwise they will be asked to put on the camera by Atul Gopal Prabhu immediately. So he'll be always checking, and so if anyone is putting off, he will be immediately ask you to put it back on. Okay.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes.
Prabhuji, one question, like I saw Mangalacharan you have read in sequence, but one word Srimad Bhagavatam Sri Mantra Deshi Kamishwaram. This was intentionally skipped, Prabhuji?
Intentionally I skipped, Prabhu.
Okay.
I will okay, discuss later.
Yeah, Prabhu. I just wanted to confirm.
Yes. Yes. Okay, slowly I will try to remember even online students also, their names, because I will ask suddenly the questions on online also. So, and also you should not put off the camera. And here we are hearing means hearing, no other activity means online. Anyway, class will be going on and I will do some other work parallelly. So that is not recommended, that is not allowed. Okay. Now, all of you, anyway, if anyone is having the, is not having, if anyone is not having their mobile and they are not able to see the notes, whatever we sent, so they should get the printout next time onwards. Otherwise, if you are having mobile, then you can see in that. So then you can get the printout of that. Or otherwise, you have laptop? You don't have laptop also. So today you can see with another friend, another one, just neighbor, whoever is there, another devotee from the another devotees. But tomorrow onwards, so, and others all are having the file, whatever I sent. Okay, distracted with the screen, okay. And Puneet, your name is? You have, na? Okay. And I'll try to remember names of all the students. Okay, I know few, but I don't know few others' name, but I will try to remember. Okay. First of all, I want to send one question. Maybe tomorrow, by the tomorrow class, before the starting of tomorrow class, you can send answer to that question. That question is, what is your expectation? What is your expectation of attending the Tattva Sandarbha class? And expectation means what things you are, because here, see, varieties of the students are there. Very exalted Vaishnavas also there. And very ekdam neophyte. Neophyte means not neophyte, I cannot say neophyte, but very new to the Krishna consciousness. And even I know some students, they didn't heard the name of Sandarbha also, actually. So it is a classroom is like is having the big difference among the students, and that's why I should know the their expectation from the class, especially the senior Vaishnavas, not especially senior Vaishnavas, everyone actually I want, so that I will see the their expectation, and then after that I will optimize the things, because I am not Krishna, so it's not that the Krishna is simultaneously he can serve to all the people in whatever the way they want. So I will try to optimize their expectations and finally bring out median of that, of all expectations, and based upon that I will go on in the class. So that's why tomorrow you can send that expectation to my message, to my number. So personal number. Okay. So Prabhu, this is my expectation of attending class. That means if you don't have any expectation, then you can also mention that. So I don't have any special expectation. Whatever you teach, I take. So if that is also your case, then you should answer in that way also. But everyone should answer. Everyone should send message. Okay. That means almost 11 o'clock. We have 1 hour time. And this is the first day. So we'll try to slowly, that means catch the speed. So our plan is like this. Total 60 anuchedas are there in this Tattva Sandarbha, and we'll try to finish within 60 hours. So that is our targeted time. I mean, even in the flyer, in the advertisement also, we announced like that. So that I should stick to that, and also I should also serve all the Vaishnavas so that they should get the more and more taste to do bhakti. The ultimate intention is studying of the Sandarbhas is to understand more and more deeply the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, and understanding Srimad Bhagavatam and by getting a taste in Srimad Bhagavatam, what will happen? Shraddha Ratir Bhaktir Anukramishyati. What Kapila Muni is saying. Tad Joshanad Apu Apu तज्ज आसु अपवर्ग वर्तमानि श्रद्धा रतिर भक्ति अनुक्रमिष्यति. सो दिस इज द मेन इंटेंशन टू गेट मोर एंड मोर फेथ इन दि श्रीम लॉर्ड सुप्रीम लॉर्ड कृष्णा एंड टू गेट द मोर रति एंड मोर भक्ति. सो भक्ति इज अ फाइनल, दैट इज अ प्रेम इन दैट श्लोक. भक्ति मीन्स प्रेम. सो दैट इज अ गोल, एक्चुअली दैट इज अ गोल ऑफ स्टडिंग दि संदर्भास. So there is a little difficulty for the online students, because camera is a little bit height, that means it is almost all top of my head actually. So that's why many times it looks like that I am seeing always down actually. So we are trying to merge the on-site and online. That is why you might be getting that kind of inconvenience. That means I'm not seeing directly to you. So such a feeling you may get. But I will try to do both ways. That means sometimes up. So to just like this, I have to put my head. That means I have to see upward direction. Then only you will feel that I'm seeing to you. Okay, I'll try to do that also. day one notes. Just we'll go for the introduction of the sandarbhas. First of all, definition of the sandarbha, that we are going to discuss first.
Prabhu, can I interrupt?
Yes, Maharaj.
First of all, I want to express my thanks that you are giving this presentation. I'm looking forward to it very much. And I just wanted to know a little more about the schedule. You have said it will be 60 hours.
Yes.
And that I understand. Will this be for a period of total 1 hour each day? And will it be 7 days a week or 5 days a week? Or can you give us a little more detail on this, please?
Yes, Maharaj. This, in the flyer also we said it is 2 months time we wrote there. My expected time, Maharaj, 60 hours, but I suspect that it will go even more, actually, maybe 10 hours more extra, maybe it is 70. So like this, that's why every day 1.5 hours of teaching will be happening for the sandarbhas, and 6 days per week, that is a plan, actually, like that, 9 hours. So 2 months, 70 hours. It's 70 hours. So 9 hours per week. And like this, 4 weeks, 36 hours. 36 into 2 months. So it's almost all. So 70 hours. So 10 hours extra I took because I need to conduct the exams also. And Viva, I will take Viva also. I will see the understanding, how the students are able to get the understanding of the subject matter. So that is the plan.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. So 36, 72 hours, right, Prabhu?
Yeah.
And is it 6 days means Monday to Saturday, right, Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhu.
Thanks, Prabhu.
Yeah. Monday to Saturday. Actually, one more point. So all the online on-site students, whatever they want to speak, they should speak in the mic only. So without taking mic, you should not speak, because online students also are there. They should hear. Otherwise, something is happening here and they are simply seeing my face. And otherwise, without hearing the question, they always hear only answer. So it will not look good, actually. So if you want to ask, so wireless cordless mic is there. So first of all, take that mic, and then after that, you can speak in that.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes.
I just want to know the study material, the books we should refer, and additional material we can use.
Yeah. One more thing, materials. So what kind of materials and what books will follow for this? So that also I need to clarify. What we are doing, we are having the BBT book for the Tattva Sandarbha, which is translated by the Gopi Paradhana Prabhu. So that you can use it for reference. And also that, and Bhanu Maharaj also translated, that also you can use it. And apart from that, I will also give the notes, because some places I felt even better. That means I try to improve translation. So that's why you can get the notes from me also. Okay. We'll be like this, we'll be going. But what I want to do, I want to publish a book with the detailed explanations. So that's why whatever the notes we are giving, that we request all of you not to share with others. Only that is for the your self-study only we are giving. So we request all of you not to share with anyone, actually. That I'm going to publish a book So I'm bringing out from my translation too and merging there. So giving as a material for you. So that's why it will be personal made. It is the personal one, but personal one means so that once book is published, then we can share to anyone. Even I don't expect anything that means from that book, but main thing is if it is published, then is there any mistake in that, they will refer to me. Otherwise, so it is given and nobody knows who is the author of that, then what will happen? So any mistake will be carried forward and there is no chance to addressing back the mistake in that. So that is the main purpose, that's why. So if there is any mistake you find in that, so you can tell, you can let me know, so we can improve. That is one more intention is, we have to see the better ideas on that text and also on that understanding. So that's why I expect deep involvement of yours also. And also we should maintain our speed of teaching. And you can ask questions when I give time. So then only you can ask. Otherwise, only discussion will happen and class will not go on. Okay, whenever I give the time, you can ask doubts, then only you ask. But if you have even serious doubt, that is really very important, then online students, they can raise the hand, and on-site students also, they can raise the hand. Okay, so that is the book. Materials are like that. So Gopi Pradhana Prabhu's book, you can refer. And I'm going to cover every line, because in the my commitment also, in the flyer also I said, every line will be discussing. Every line means the meaning of every line we are going to discuss, but Sanskrit line, I am not going to teach to you. That means how to understand the Sanskrit line, that will not be covered. Only the meaning of that Sanskrit line will be covered. But from that Sanskrit word, how to get the meaning, so that will be very difficult because many are not having the Sanskrit background. So that is a very difficult. But line by line, every line meaning we'll discuss in English language, and like this, we'll get the subject matter. But Sanskrit understanding, if you want, then you meet me personally. Then we'll, if you have any doubt, you try yourself, and if you have any doubt, then I can explain. You have to break this samasa like this and get the meaning like this. And after that, this is the sandhi here you should do. Like this, I will tell all those. And also we have 70 hours, so that to maintain the speed also, we need to go with that. So, but when you learn the Sanskrit language also, so then in the final year, maybe 3 year students also they're here. So for them, we'll be teaching the how to do anvaya or how to take out the English meaning from the Sanskrit, that we will teach to them. So, but for the students who are staying for 1 year and who registered for only course, so that is not possible actually. Okay. So this is the way I proceed further. And also one more point, I will cover points from the Sarvasamvadini also. Sarvasamvadini is not exactly the commentary on the Mula. First of all, Sandarbha, how the text looks. Sandarbha is having the one Mula, that's the main text, and also Sarvasamvadini. Sarvasamvadini is almost all is like a one kind one new compilation only. It is not exactly the commentary, word to word commentary of the Mula, but it is a parallel text. It's a similar to the Mula, so that's why it is useful to study the Mula. So sometimes wherever we need, there I will also teach from the Sarvasamvadini. But I am not promising that entire Sarvasamvadini I am not going to cover, because some portions, even some places are, I have to get the clarification. Still, I am working on that. So like this, about the Sarvasamvadini. So many people very much interested, and many times they heard Sandarbha. It's a pulling sabda, Sandarbha. So anyone of you know the meaning of Sandarbha? Raise the hands. Sandarbha. Do you know? Yes, bro. Mike.
Sandarbha in our language, day to day, it's used for
to find something or anusandhan, like
to find
anusandhan.
Anusandhan.
Yeah, find out.
Find out. Yes. Yes. Prabhu, take mic and you can say what is sandarbha.
It is like a condensed milk.
It is like a condensed milk. Very good. Sandarbha is a condensed milk, like condensed milk. It's not condensed milk, it is like condensed milk. Okay, very good. And online students?
Is it also the context of the object?
It is also context of the object. Okay.
Hare Krishna.
Yes.
It means in relation to Sandarbha.
Sandarbha means a relation.
In relation to.
Okay, don't read my notes and tell from that. You might be doing that. When I ask, then you can do that. But before that, don't do. Otherwise, they will give the notes after the class. If you do like that. So that's why. Okay, Sandarbha, you are all having the different opinions. Okay, good. Sandarbha, this definition is given in the Baldev Vidya Bhushan's commentary. Okay, so the definition of Sandarbha is like this. What is that problem? Who's Sachidev, Prabhu?
Yeah, Sandarbha means arranging something.
Prabhu, can you put on the camera?
Prabhuji, I have already given the reason to your co-host why I cannot do it.
Huh?
I have given the reason to your co-host why I cannot on the camera, because I'm in office and the cameras are not allowed in office videos.
Okay.
So I've given the reason in writing, and I've also given the reason to you in writing on the comments. Prabhuji, Sandarbha means arranging words or something like that.
Oh, arranging words. Okay. Okay. So, we'll see now. Sandarbha definition is gudarthasya prakashascha saroktihi sreshtata tatha nanardavatvam vedyatvam sandarbha katyate budhaihi. This is the definition of the sandarbha. So, what is the, can anyone read the translation? Yes.
The wise say a sandarbha is the revelation of the deep meanings of the main text, is excellence of the main text, is an exposition of the essence, and is the various meanings which should be known
of the
main text.
Okay. Not this one, no? This only? Sandarbha notes, no. This one, no? Okay. Hmm? Just I want to open the entire thing. Very slow net. Anyway. It's not defined by Baldev Jabushan, but he mentioned this in his commentary on Tattva Sandarbha. Okay?
Okay.
What, try to understand the meaning. The wise say a Sandarbha is the revelation of the deep meaning, deep meanings of the main text is excellence, is an exposition of the essence, and is the various meanings which should be known. So in this sloka, if you see, gudardhasya prakashaha, gudardha, gudardha means deep meanings, prakashaha means revelation. Revelation. Gudarthasya prakasha. Next. Yeah. You can see from there. Yeah. Sreshtata tatha. Sreshtata tatha. Sreshtata means excellence. And sarukti is the excellence. That means it's a sara actually. And sarukti is the essence, is an exposition of the essence. And it just, it is shifted, it should, we should shift first. Excellence should come later. And is an exposition of the essence. That is the second. Saruktihi is the, is an exposition of the essence. Saruktihi. And Sreshtata means excellence. Okay. Nanardhavattvam vedyattvam. So nanardhavattvam vedyattvam is the meaning, is various meanings which should be known. So this one has to be shifted, because it should follow the krama. So who, for the Bhagava Sandarbha, Shat Sandarbhas are also known as Bhagava Sandarbha. First of all, you should understand, Sandarbha is nothing but the compilation of the deep meanings of deep meanings. So sarokti gudardasya prakashaha, otherwise it's a revelation of the deep meanings. It's it itself, the book is having what, this book Sandarbha book is having the, so revelation of the deep meanings and also exposition of the essence, and next excellence, that means the sreshtata, the supremacy of that main text, and also it is having the nanardhavattvam vedyattvam. So the many meanings should be known. So it is also having that. This is known as Sandarbha. That means Sandarbha is not a independent book. From this you should understand, Sandarbha is not a independent book. Like the right side, the word right side is independent word or not? Is it having the, directly it can give the meaning? After hearing the right side, then what kind of doubt you'll get? Yeah, that means immediately you'll get, it's right side to whom? Whom? You'll ask, yes or no? Back, if you say back, the word back is not independently, it will not give the meaning. It will give the meaning with the some other one only. That means back of whom? You'll ask or not? So similarly, Sandarbha, after hearing Sandarbha, so you should get immediately, it is on which? It is on which? So these are all known as relative words actually. Relative words. They are not the independent words. Like you see, Ramaha word is independent. It is a name of the person. But
If you see the right or left or the far, near, all these words are the relative words. They need the some other support actually to get the full meaning. So similarly, sandarbha is the essence of what? Which? What is the main text? Whose essence? So that's why that kind of doubt we get. So sandarbha is a relative word. Now, then we are going to study sandarbha of what? What? Sandarbha of Bhagavatam. Sandarbha of Bhagavatam. That's why it is known as Bhagavata Sandarbha. It is known as Bhagavata Sandarbha. And also it is divided into 6 parts. That's why it is another name is Shat Sandarbha. 6 Sandarbhas. So Bhagavat Sandarbha or otherwise Shat Sandarbha. So that means this book, whatever we are going to study, that means Shat Sandarbha, Bhagavat Sandarbha. This book, what it will do then? What this will do then? This Bhagavat Sandarbha will do what? Sandarbha, what is you understood? Then in the place of main text, you put the Bhagavatam. Then make the sentence. So who is going to tell? Tell in the mic. What Bhagavat Sandarbha will do? What it is having? Bhagavat Sandarbha is having what?
It will give the essence of the Bhagavatam.
No. Directly you can read from that. Okay.
It will give us the good artha of Srimad
Bhagavatam. Sandarbha is the
revelation of
deep
Shrimad
meanings
Bhagavatam.
Of
Srimad Bhagavatam. Is exposition of the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. Is excellence of Srimad Bhagavatam. And it also gives various meaning which should be known from Srimad Bhagavatam.
That means this Shat Sandarbha or otherwise Bhagavat Sandarbha is having revelation of the deep meanings of Bhagavatam. And also it is having the exposition of the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. That means the Sarukti. It is going to tell the essence. This is Bhagavat Sandarbha is having the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. And Bhagavat Sandarbha is also having this excellence of the Srimad Bhagavatam. That means how the Srimad Bhagavatam is supreme compared to other scriptures. So that is also it is having. And this Sandarbha is having what else? It is having the various meanings to be known of the Bhagavatam. So that's why if anyone wants to know Bhagavatam, then what he has to do? He has to read Sandarbhas also. Yes? That is the importance of the Shat Sandarbhas. So what is our life and soul? Our life and soul. For Gaudiya Vaishnavas, what is the life and soul? Is the Srimad Bhagavatam. So we have to study. So Srimad Bhagavatam, that is the life and soul. By studying Srimad Bhagavatam, what we'll get as a devotee? Yeah. First of all, we'll get the Shraddha. Then after that, we'll get the Rati. Then after that, we'll get the Bhakti. Anukramishyati. That means it will come one after one. Will it come at a time, everything? Will it come at a time or not? Shraddha, Ratir, Bhaktir, Anukramishyati. Step by step, or can it come at a time? At one time? Just in 1 second? It will come. What is the sloka is saying? It will come at one time, in that moment itself it will come. Sadyo hrudyavarudhya krutibhi shushushubhi tatkshanat. Just by hearing one time the holy name, you will be getting that means you will be experiencing the Supreme Lord. It is also possible. Then what is the difference between these two? Anyway, we are just a little discussing about the Bhagavatam. What is the difference? There, Kapil Bhagavan is saying, Shraddha, Ratir, Bhaktir, Anukramishyati. And here in the Mangalacharan Sloka, Vyasadeva is saying, Sadhyo Hurud Yavarudjite Krutibihi Shushushbihi Tat Kshanat. On that moment itself, he'll be experiencing the Supreme Lord. Then why difference is there? Shushushbihi Tat Kshanat. Tat Kshanat. Just Krutibihi. So actually, the reason is, when the first one is applicable, when the second one is applicable. Both are true, because both are from the Srimad Bhagavatam. But the conditions are changed. What is that conditions? For the first one, that means Kapil Dev said, Shraddha, Ratir, Bhaktir, Anukrameshati, what is the condition? So in whose case it happens? The devotees who are having the anarthas. So that's why it is a process. Adho Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Bhajana Kriya, Anardha Nivritti. That's why Yustana Chakra Thakur, Rupa Goswami is expanding those. That means those steps. So in the case, why we have to take so many lifetimes to get the prema of the Supreme Lord? What is the reason? What is the stopping element in us? Only one thing, that is anartha. That is only the main. That's why, so because of the anarthas only, this whole devotional ladder is made in the different stages. But if you don't have any anartha, then immediately on the spot, you'll be getting the experience of the Lord. That means prema ankura you'll get. But prema gadata, that means the condensed state of the love, that will come by the Lord's mercy only. So, but prema you will get, ankura you will get immediately, just one name, if you don't have any anardas, jivan anardas. But we are not getting means, then is only the reason is anardas. That is the main important point. So anyway, now come to our discussion. That is Bhagavatam. So next, how many sandarbhas are there? Total 6 sandarbhas are there. What are those names? Can anyone tell? 6 sandarbhas. Yes, Prabhu. Mike.
Tattva sandarbha. Priti sandarbha.
No. Line.
Sequence.
Kram. Sequence.
Okay. Tattva sandarbha. Paramatma sandarbha.
No.
Bhagavat sandarbha.
Okay. Some other one can try. Online students.
Prabhuji, Tattva sandarbha. Uh-huh. Bhagavat sandarbha. Priti sandarbha. Bhakti sandarbha.
No.
Prabhuji, shall I try? Tattva Sandarvas, then Bhagavad Sandarvas, then Krishna Paramatma Sandarvas, then Krishna Sandarva, then Bhakti Sandarva.
Krishna after Krishna what?
Prabhuji, Tattva Sandarvas, then Bhagavad Sandarvas, then Paramatma Sandarvas, then Krishna Sandarvas, then Bhakti Sandarvas, and Priti Sandarvas.
Yes.
Okay.
That is a sequence. Mm-hmm. These are the 6 sandarbhas. These 6 sandarbhas are categorized based upon the Anubandha Chatushtayam. So we are going to study in just future classes. Any author, if he wants to write a book, so he will be setting he will be following the 4 parameters to write a book. Everyone has to, every author, so follow some system actually. So those 4 parameters, based upon that only he will write his book, and also he will organize the chapters of that book. What are those 4 parameters? Anyone know? What are those? Mike.
subject last.
That
sambandha, adhikari, sambandha, prayojan and vishay.
Yeah.
Adhikari, the
adhikari
is criteria to the person, then sambandha, then prayojan and vishaya.
Okay. So these first one is, if you want to write book, first of all you have to understand what is the vishaya you want to mention in that book. What vishaya you want? Vishaya means subject matter. On what vishaya, on what subject matter you want to write a book, that you have to decide first. What is that vishaya? Okay, vishaya is necessary. And after that, sambandha. Sambandha means, sambandha word is having the, is needed two things. What are that? Two relatas are necessary. Sambandha means between whom? Between whom? This immediately will get down this doubt. Sambandha. So if you want to write book, first of all, on what subject matter you are going to write, that you have to decide. That is vishaya, first one. And second one is, so you are writing book and you are discussing about the subject matter, that means vishaya. So the relation between the book and subject matter is known as sambandha. Sambandha means between whom? Between the book and subject matter. This is the sambandha. Then after that, what the process you are going to recommend for your audience in that book. So you'll be prescribing the some process in that. That's a prescribed process in that book, or recommended process in that book for the audience is the abhidheya. Is the abhidheya. And after following that process, what you are going to get, that is prayojana. And some people, they consider adhikari is also one of the parameter. So that means in the place of vishaya, some people may take adhikari, sambandha, abhidheya, prayojana. This is the one set of anubandha chatushtaya. One more anubandha chatushtaya is what? Vishaya, sambandha, abhidheya, prayojan. Anything is okay. For example, we are trying to understand this anubandha chatushtaya. For example, you want to write a book. You are a doctor. Let us assume you are a doctor, and you want to write a book for the about the disease, one disease, cancer. Okay. So here you are going to write a book on the what subject matter? Disease, cancer. Okay. Here vishaya is the cancer disease. And what is a sambandha? That means what way you want to define in this book about the cancer? You want to make a manual, or you want to make a handbook, or you want to make a just research work? What is the relation this book is having with the that subject matter? That is known as, that means what way? Handbook. That means this book, whatever book you are going to write, that is the just useful for the doctors only, or it is useful for the patients only. It is useful for the, so like the medicines they give, what we say, medicines they give, pharmacist, is for the pharmacist only. You have to define that. That is known as sambandha. That means how this book is dealing with that, how this book is dealing with that subject matter is known as relation, sambandha. Getting? Getting or not? Online students? Okay. Okay. Just another two things I will finish and then I will come to the questions. So next one is what? Next one is Abhideya. Abhideya means the process. Let us take this book for the patients. Now you will be saying these are precautions you should take to not get this disease. And if you get this, you are in the early stage, then this is the method, this is the process you have to follow to cure the disease. And otherwise, if it is a severe case, then you have to follow this procedure. That means the procedure recommended for the audience is known as Abhideya. Abhideya. Then after that, what is the result? Result is, that means by following that Abhideya, the process, you will be getting the result, that is a prayojana. That means you will be cancer-free life. So what kind of benefits you will be getting? So that is the result. So like this, any book you want to write, these four things we should define. So first of all, in the author himself, in the mind, he will be thinking about these four things. And then he will write. That means it's not that I want to write book and let me take pen and paper and he will be starting and writing. Is it like that? No, he will be organizing. He is understanding what he wants to do first. Yes? Yes or no? What is the practicality? Okay, what are your question? Mike.
This someone that looks like very much to Adhikari. Who is for whom we are writing?
It's not exactly Adhikari. So you can derive actually.
From Sambandha, we can derive Adhikari.
Even from the Sambandha, you can derive the Vishaya also.
From Sambandha, we can derive Vishaya also.
So that's why what I said, Sambandha will be there and Adhikari and Vishaya is the, it is changing.
Yeah.
You're getting or not? If you define Vishaya and the Sambandha is also okay, you can, from the Sambandha, you can derive the, almost all you can understand the Adhikari. Otherwise, if you define Sambandha and from that, you can also understand the, what is the Vishaya. Getting or not?
Yeah, and one more clarification. So in this, they are not specifically speaking about Adhikari because in the book, they are not describing about Adhikari. They are just describing the relationship of Adhikari with the subject.
No, not relationship with the Adhikari with the subject. Relationship with the book with the subject matter. Relationship between the book with the subject matter.
Sorry to ask.
And this means this book is talking about that subject matter in what fashion, what manner.
Okay.
In what way? That means it is a handbook, or it is the manual, or it is the data book, or it is the descriptions or something like that. Like example, you take Tarkasangraha. I don't know how many of you know. Tarkasangraha, all of you, anyone know Tarkasangraha? Tarkasangraha is a Nyaya book. It's a basic book, Nyaya book. This is what is doing, what is subject matter of this Tarka Sangraha? Sapta Padardaha, seven elements. What are the seven elements? Okay. Dravya, Guna, Karma, Samanya, Vishesha, Samavaya, and Abhav. These are the seven Padardas. This Tarka Sangraha is discussing about these seven Padardas. That's why Vishaya is what? Seven elements, seven padardhas is the Vishaya. And this book is going to do what about those seven padardhas? This book is going to nirupaka. That means it is proving the definitions of those seven padardhas. So that's why it is what? Nirupaka. And seven padardhas are what? Nirupya. That means they are being established. And this book is establisher, and those seven padardas are established. Is going up or down?
No, we are understanding.
Yeah. I want to use this. Madhav, this. Just I will make a little. Yeah, once again I will come. Zoom ko open karke. Zoom hai. Id connected ha. Screen sharing. Okay. First time I'm also learning actually. Okay. This is Sambandha. Relatas. Are hot erase. Yeah. Stop one. Yeah. Where is that? This. Yeah. Okay. No. Okay. ఇప్పుడు మళ్ళీ మాడు రావాలంటే ఓకే అన్నో ఎనీవే I'm taking time, so don't mind. Just like children starting. So it's the first day, so how the first day, if you give a pen to the children, so how they will feel difficulty, I'm also feeling. But I have to practice, because otherwise we cannot stand up and do the things. It will take so much time. So, relator. There will be two relators. And it is having okay, little bit spelling mistakes. I am not able to erase this, so don't mind. There are two relators, and this is a relation. Relation is there, and this is what one relator is what book, and another is what is the subject. Subject matter, Vishaya. This is Vishayaha. Okay, now example Tarka Sangraha. If you come to Tarka Sangraha, so book is what? Tarka Sangraha. Okay, eraser. Okay, in my car. Okay, no problem. Select now. Tarka Sangra, where is this? Huh? Huh? Okay. Tarka Sangraha is the book. And what is the Vishaya for this? Seven Padardas. Seven elements. And what is the relation? Like the, you see, Var is actually where is that? Gachare gaya. Point. Okay. So for example, you take Rama. One is Rama. And another is what? Dasharadha. दशरथः रामः कुछ उन प्रॉब्लम को वन रिलेटा इज द रामः अनदर इज दशरथः व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन दीस टू पुत्र पितृ संबंधः सन फादर relation son father relation you have between the Rama and the Dashrathaha so similarly tarka sangraha and the seven elements he is having what sambandha this is tarka sangraha is the nirupakaha devanagari is okay Devanagari is okay?
Yes.
Online students, yes.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Yeah. And what is the Vishaya? What is seven elements? Seven elements are the Nirupya. Nirupya. Oh, spelling. Nirupya. This eraser I will bring. Nirupya, very good. Oh, Prabhu, button mein bhi rehta hai kya? Itna chota hai, kanu padna hai, dikhi nahi rahi hai. Okay, acha. Okay, I got it. Nirupakaha and Nirupya. What is the meaning of Nirupakaha? This book is going to define, prove. And these seven elements are to be proved. This is going to prove and these elements are to be proved. That's why what is the relation between the Tarka Sangraha and the seven elements? What is the relation between Tarka Sangraha and the seven elements?
Praman and Prameya.
Who is that? Praman and Prameya? From where it came?
Okay, I said Mahatsevadas.
Okay. What is your name, Prabhu?
Mahatsevadas.
Mahatseva, Prabhu. There is no Pramana and no Prameya. This is the Nirupakaha and this is the Nirupiha. That's why what is the relation? Nirupaka Nirupya Sambandha. What is the relation?
Nirupya Sambandha.
Rama is the son and Dasaratha is the father. What is the son?
Son, father.
And Tarka Sangraha is the Nirupaka. Seven elements are the Nirupyaha. So then what is the relation? Nirupaka Nirupya
Sambandha.
Okay. Is there any difficulty?
No problem.
Huh?
Can you come again, please? The last line that you said about Nirupak and Rupya.
Can you give one example with a book, some book, practical book? Okay, this book is there,
yeah.
And this is subject matter. And what sub material which defining the Nirupak and Nirupya relationship?
Yeah. Nirupakaha. So Mataji is asking what she is asking the last line. What I am saying, we are seeing Anubandha Chatushtaya means. So first is Vishaya, Sambandha, Abhideya, and Prayojana. These are the four parameters. So are there to be observed to write any book? Out of these four parameters, so second one, Sambandha is the many students are having little problem to understand this. So now Sambandha means what I am saying. Sambandha means it is a relation between the book and the subject matter. So I am taking one example for this, and that book is Tarka Sangraha. And what is the relation? What is the subject matter of Tarka Sangraha? Seven elements. So this book is going to tell about what? That means it is going to do what about seven elements? Is it defining, or is it proving, or is it just mentioning, or what? Or is it going to tell about the just use of them? Okay, this book should be becoming something to those seven elements. It is maintaining some relation with the seven elements. Yes or no, you're getting? So like Rama is having with Dasaratha, with what relation? He is having the relation of son. So that means son and father relation. Similarly, this book is telling about those seven elements in what way? Is it just mentioning, or is it just defining, or is it just establishing? So this book is going to do the nirupakaha. That means it is establishing those. So that's why this book is becoming the nirupakaha, and those subject matter is becoming the nirupya. That's why this book is having the sambandha of
nirupaka nirupya.
Nirupaka nirupya sambandha. Okay.
Yes, understood. Thank you.
So let's take the Prabhuji. So let's take the book Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Then how can we relate with Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu book?
Oh, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu book is there, and it is, what is the subject matter of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu?
Bhakti.
Is the bhakti, pure devotional service. So this book is doing what? This book is defining, or is it giving the entire, it is like encyclopedia of that, or is it like just defining and leaving that, or otherwise it is telling about the uses of simply that bhakti, or is it, that means this Bhakti Rasamrita is a manual of that, what do you have to know? So what it is doing, Bhakti Rasamrita is doing?
It is defining pure devotion service.
It is defining his pure devotional service. Then it is just, it is telling about that. Then it is the book is the vachakaha, and that bhakti is the vacha. That's why it is having the sambandha of vachaka vacha sambandha.
Vachaka vacha sambandha. Okay.
Okay. So nirupi.
Yes, Prabhuji, clearly understood now.
Yeah. So like this, Jiva Goswami is going to write a book. He also want to write a book called Six Sandarbhas. So before writing the book, he has to plan what is the subject matter of this and what is the relation. That means in what way he want to explain in this book about those subject matter. That also he has to first itself, he has to define. He has to first, that has to be in the mind. Yes or no? And then after that, Abhideya and Prayojana. So, Shat Sandarbhas, Bhagavata Sandarbha is the book he is writing. And what is the Vishaya of the Bhagavata Sandarbha? Sri Krishna. Krishna is the Vishaya of the Bhagavata Sandarbha. And this Sandarbha is doing what? That means this Sandarbha is in what way this Sandarbha is dealing with. This book is dealing with that subject matter. This book is dealing with that subject matter. What is that dealing? It is the Vachakaha. Book is Vachakaha, and Krishna is the Vacha. That's why this Bhagavat Sandarbha or Sat Sandarbha is having what kind of relation with the Krishna? Vachaka Vacha Sambandha. Okay? Vachakaha, vacha, this word. Like nirupaka, nirupya, we have the vachakaha, vachaha. Like this is what? This is pen. The word pen, P-E-N, pen, is the what? Vachakaha, this. Vachakaha. And this pen, the object pen is what? Vachaha, meaning. Vacha means meaning. That's why, so the word pen and the object pen is having the what kind of relation? Vachaka, vacha. No, the word pen and the object pen is having the vachaka, vacha sambandha. And the object pen and the word vachaka is having the vacha, vachaka sambandha. So Rama and Dasaratha is having the what kind of relation? Son and father relation. Dasaratha and Rama is having the father and son relation. Okay.
This vachya and vachaka and vachya is the same as the nirupya and nirupaka.
No, about a lot of differences there. So nirupaka is actually filtering. That means the definitions of the seven padarthas you are doing, and this nirupaka is thoroughly actually examining the definition of that and showing the consequences. If you don't define like this, so what are the different difficulties you'll get? Then finally, it is coming to the filtered definition. That's why it is nirupakaha.
Okay.
Tarka Sangraha book is nirupakaha. Okay, so like this, vachya vachaka sambandha. Okay, I will take later. So when I allow you, then you can. So vachya vachaka sambandha, it is having. Who is having what? Who are the two relators in this? In our Bhagavad Sandarbha case, you tell me. Take mic. I will ask. I have free will to ask. Okay.
Vachaka vachya sambandha.
Who is having who?
Book is the vachaka and Krishna is vachya. Yeah.
Book is the
vachaka.
Krishna is the
vachya.
Okay. Vachya vachaka. Vachaka vachya sambandha he is having. So who is going to tell about the definition of sandarbha? Tell. Tapomai. What is the definition of sandarbha? What you understood? Sandarbha means? देखिए बोलेंगे देखो यू वांट टू सी एंड टेल सो हूम आई वांट टू सेलेक्ट ऑनलाइन स्टूडेंट एनीवन हाँ यस टेल प्रभु व्हाट इज संदर्भ डेफिनेशन ऑफ संदर्भ One, you go first two time. We are lifted first. They.
Hare Krishna.
The
definition of sandarbha is gudaratasya prakashascha. That is deep meaning and revolution. Shreshta. That is excellence.
Shreshta, not shreshtata.
Shreshtata, tata. That
not,
is excellence.
Shreshtata.
Shreshtata. And then
Shreshtata. Okay.
Shreshtata. And then Sharoktihi, that is exposition of essence, and Nana Artha Vatvam, Nana Artha Vatvam Vedyatvam, that is various meanings which should be known, deeper meanings. So this is the definition of Sandarbha.
This is the definition of the Sandarbha. So we are going to tell about which Sandarbha, we are going to discuss about which Sandarbha that. Mujjwal. Jiva Goswami wrote what Sandarbha? Tell in the mic.
Bhagavat Sandarbha.
Bhagavat Sandarbha. So we are going to discuss about the Bhagavat Sandarbha. So any book if you want to write, what you have to check, what parameters you should need to check, wait. Bhavagrahi Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Yeah.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah.
One is Vishaya, Sambandha, Abhideya, and Prayojana.
Vishaya, Sambandha, Abhideya, Prayojana. Okay. What is the meaning of Sambandha, Prabhu? Give the mic to him.
Sambandha means relation between the two subjects.
Relation between?
The writer. Book and...
Why you are telling?
Sambandha means
between whom? Sambandha between
the one is writer who is going to write.
Writer and
writer.
No, okay.
One writer.
Reader.
And who is to whom he is going to write?
No, actually, it is the relation between the book and subject matter. Okay, no problem. You can try later. So next, what is the abhideya? So. Radharani Mataji. I want to remember the names. I am not able to see very far. Okay, I will see from here.
Abhideya is the process of process, Prabhuji.
Abhideya is process.
Process.
Prabhu, why these are not coming in my screen? Oh, screen share I should remove, huh? This, huh? Yeah, yeah, okay, okay. 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 So one more. Finally, Prayojana. So what is the Prayojana? Say all.
Result.
Result of what? Result of book?
Result after of the book? Following.
Result of
after
the book.
Following that process, what will you get?
Okay. So like this, we today learned just very first class so that there is a need to get this synchronization. There is a, first, if you want to have a communication between two entities, there is a need to establish the first, what is necessary? Synchronization. They should be in the same, that means a link should be established. Then the data will flow. So that's why we are trying to just have a synchronization. That means between me and all of you. So tomorrow onwards, we'll speed up the our program. Okay. So it is at 12 o'clock. Thank you very much. So I just say thanks to all of you. Vancha kalpatarubhyascha krupa sindhubhya eva cha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha.
Prabhuji, tomorrow is holiday.
Jai.
Prabhuji, tomorrow is a holiday.
Day of tomorrow. Okay.
Prabhuji, we don't have your phone number. Can you just mention it to us? Because you had asked us to send the WhatsApp, no?
In WhatsApp, actually, that WhatsApp group, if you, not creator. My number is 6.
No, the WhatsApp group is created, but only admins are allowed to actually send messages.
Okay. 6394560.
6394.
Yeah. I can put in my WhatsApp so you can write from there. In that group, I will mention number.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Dhanavad Pranam.
Prabhu, tomorrow there is no class, right?
Day after tomorrow, we'll be having class.
Okay.
So Hare Krishna. We'll start discussing about the Mangalacharan slokas, that 8 slokas. First sloka, we'll finish in the first sloka. We'll try to finish in the first class. Okay, thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada.
Thank you.
Jai.
Yeah. Thank you, Puji. Dhanavad Pranam.
Pranam. Very good. No problem. But too many questions means class will not go further. No? That's if you whatever doubts you have, you can ask after the class. Okay. Sanskrit class 26th onwards, day after tomorrow. Will be starting. Yes, bro. Okay. Schedule today, tomorrow we will be working on that actually. That's a new teacher. Yeah. We thought another teacher, so somehow he is not coming. So he's a new teacher, so we have to work out. But the main schedule will be the simple Sanskrit only we give, basic fundamentals. Yes. Next class. Next class, Kanai Krishna Prabhu will be coming. So, half an hour break.